You've been with the Blasters for Afcon tournament as assistant coach. Can you tell us your first encounter with Mr. Atsu?
I'm very happy with what we've seen here today. I mean, Ghanaians have done well. The media houses, everybody. For Atsu to get a state barrier, this is what we were all campaigning for. I mean, we have to say a big thank you to the president of the country, Nana Akufo-Addo. And then the elders who made this possible. Wherever Atsu is today, you look back and say thank you, Ghana. You have really supported the program, including with the media houses. You carried the life across the world, and everybody is very happy about it.
What's that one thing you remember Atsu from your encounter with him as Blasters assistant coach?
So I remember one goal that he scored. They have gone 2015. He scored the goal that
the goal of the tournament.
I won the goal of the tournament. So anytime I think about Atsu, I think about that goal.
Then he talks about his charity work and all of that. And others also tell him some of his teammates to follow him. What would be your advice to other footballers who are also earning good money and how they can impact the community?
Yeah, everybody have a style of living. He was living for the people, but we can only encourage others to follow or learn from what the young Atsu did. I mean, whatever he earned, he's been giving a lot to the poor and the needy. And that, to follow him wherever he is, so we encourage more people to learn from him. It's a good act.